What are you doing?
So you was just talking about something?
You're the one who's been out gallivanting around here.
That's what you call it. Clearly you've recovered from your bear encounter.
Could have played that better, couldn't you?
Thought you wanted me here to show some strong arm. That's usually how it goes.
Yes, but you know how this works.
Come on, Hosea. That fella's a joke.
And that's why he's perfect. He won't cause us any problems. A safe spot to fence wagons and coaches, that's easy money for us.
I guess you're right.
Come on, it's not like he's asking us to rob a bank. If the two of us can't steal a stagecoach from Seamus's old crooked cousin by marriage, we should hang up our hats now.
So what's the story with that Emerald Ranch? You find out anything else?
A little. Owner's a nasty type by all accounts. Seamus is sure scared of him.
That's not saying much.
Something strange about the place. There's the house. You see the barn in the back. Stagecoach has to be in there.
Anyone around?
Yes. Okay. I reckon we could do it now. I'll head over, distract him by putting on a little show while you sneak into the house, find what you can, then get the stagecoach. Or wait until nightfall. Sneak in, then I'll get the coach. You can try the house. What do you think?
Let's do it now.
Sure. All right, then. Don't follow me. Wait until I have them distracted outside, then sneak into the house. My good young man. Fare thee well. Is your father home, son?
Sure is.
Get him down. Please, get him down here.
Get lost, mister.
I was lost for many years. I was lost many years. Now I'm not. And you know what? Oh, here he is. Are you the father of the house?
Sure.
Pleasure to meet you. I was just chatting with Junior here a bit.
You sell us something, partner? Great! Spinal alignment.
What?
Spinal alignment, the Lord God Almighty.
Or whomever built us.
Our brains in here, but our souls is in our backs.
You, sir, your back looks kind of tricky.
Sure.
I can fix it for you. Just stand it for 15 sessions. Whiskey 65.
door, me. I got some magic.
Seriously, it's all about the book. That better just...
Done, Arthur?
Yep.
Okay, let's grab this stagecoach and get out of here. Anything we can get right now.
This was easier than hunting a 1,000-pound grizzly anyway.
Get on, Arthur. We don't have time to mess around here.
Okay.
So what were you talking about before?
This was easier than hunting a 1,000-pound grizzly anyway.
No doubt. I won't forget that in a hurry.
I'm looking forward to your retelling of that one around the campfire.
It wasn't the first time Mr. Matthews had stared death in the eye, and as usual, he did not flinch.
Exactly. How long you think we're gonna stick around here for?
Not sure. Till we can't, I suppose. Feels like we're starting to get back on our feet, slowly but surely. Just need to keep at it. Okay, here we are. Just pull the coat. into the barn there.
Yep.
Hello, Seamus. We met your cousins.
How was it?
Fine. Nice people.
Park that thing in here. Quickly. Nice work, Hosea.
It was mostly Arthur. Like I said, coarse but competent.
Here.
Thank you.
If you find any other coaches that need selling, I'll see what I can offer you for them. But discreet, you know.
Of course.
Goodbye, gentlemen.
I'm heading back to camp, I think. You coming?
Sure.
Hello, Arthur.
Hey, Bill.
Did you find much in the O'Driscoll's cabin?
We did all right out of it. There's no coal.
Hello, Arthur.
So, we found the O'Driscoll's hideout, but no sign of coal.
Well, so long as we're hitting them before they hit us.
Shame about them calendar boys, I reckon.
Sure.
You know, I once saw Mac beat up 15 sailors.
They ain't nothing. Everybody knows them Navy boys can't fight. That's why they don't.
That's so.
Sure.
Hi there, Arthur.
They ain't nothing. I once beat up 20.
Okay.
But, I'm gonna miss Mac. He was a good man. Kind of fellow you like to rob alongside?
Yeah.
You know? Heartless son of a bitch. But he had
good
a heart.
Evening.
That makes any sense.
I know what you mean.
Evening.
R.I.P., Mac.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan, for sparing me like that. I'll work hard. I am not a bad fella. You'll soon warm to me.
You'll see that I do.
Oh, you will.
Boy. Thank you for saving my life.
Well, yeah, of course.
Room here if you want, Arthur.
That all got a little messy, huh?
I reckon it's best if we just put it behind us.
Suits me. I was just thinking about that Cornwall train. You did good there.
Nearly didn't make it.
Made it more than the rest of them.
Dear Arthur, I've written this letter 100 times or more, and I cannot get it right. It's me. You know it's me from the bad handwriting. I know I said when we last spoke, and I was going off to get married, that we would not speak again. I know I said a lot of things, and I meant them, I suppose, at the time. But I'm not so proud as to not speak to people who care for me, or cared for me. I've been in Valentine for a couple of months. I had some bad luck, and, well, it's a long story and not an interesting one. But I am here for now. I saw a couple of the girls, or whatever the polite term is for them, that ran with you and your associates in town. And I heard tell of a man who sounded like you. I would love to see you again. If you could spare me a little bit of your time. I'm renting a room at Chadwick Farm, just north of Valentine. Yours, Mary Linton.
Delicious.
Mr. Morgan, can I? Are you okay?
Yes. Miles away, I'm afraid.
So it seems. Anyway, it's that fellow Downs.
The do-gooder?
Exactly. We lent him quite a sum. It seems like he has little intention of repaying us. He was quite ridiculous when I went to see him. You've not been to see him yet, I take it?
I'm sorry, Harris Charles. Had a lot on. I'll go give him a gentle reminder.
Not so gentle. I don't like his kind. Superior.
As you wish.
Thank you.
Mr. Downs! 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 Oh, Mr. Downs! Downs! Where are you? Downs! Oh, Mr. Downs! Thomas Downs!
Come here. Hey, boy. Hello, boy. Mr. Thomas Downs?
Yep, that's me.
You owe me money.
No, I'm...
We ain't a charity, Mr. Downs. Oh, come here, you maggot.
Please, sir. I'll...
Really? Threaten me, would you?
Please, I have a family, sir. Please.
I don't care about your family. Why'd it have to come to this, huh?
This is not forgiveness of my debt. This is just a stay.
You ain't such a do-gooder, are you? If you're running out on debts...
I'm not running anywhere. I'm doing my best for you.
Pay the money. You borrowed money from my business partner, Herr Strauss. You owe him, you took the money.
He wants it back, what's not to understand? Where's our money?
I don't have it.
Sell your place.
We already owe more than it's worth.
Then sell your wife, or your family, or something. We ain't your idea of charity. Is that clear?
Thomas!
What are you looking at?
Thomas!
I said, what you looking at, woman?
My husband isn't well. If we could just have more...
Like I said, we ain't nobody's idea of charity. Get us the money.
Put something warm on, would you?
Good haul, boy.
Ah, how did you get on?
Not so good. He's almost dead. And they seem more or less destitute. You were a fool for lending them the money.
Well, people who aren't desperate don't seem so interested in my propositions.
Of course.